And it seemed to me the stupidest problem you could conceivably imagine that led to the most complicated answer you could conceivably imagine. I was in Cambridge. I finished a lecture course, two lectures early, and then I sort of hinted, I said the university regulations or something demand that I turn up on Friday, but you don't have to turn up on Friday. And I thought they'd taken the hint, because when I get to the classroom, there was usually, you know, a classroom with 150 people in it, you can usually hear some chatter and so on, but it was all quiet. And then I opened the door and they said, "Surprise!" And they'd equipped it all for a party. Some of the girls wore nice long party dresses. None of the boys wore long party dresses, or if they did, they were indistinguishable from girls. But anyway, one of them came up to me with this problem. He said, "1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1." And I gathered that I was supposed to guess what came next. And I didn't succeed. It says 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1. And he looked at me, and I still didn't guess. And he said 3, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1. And I knew from the way he was saying it that somehow I was supposed to be able to guess. I still didn't. 1, 3, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 1. Anyway, it was quite interesting in this party, but I didn't guess. And I suppose I should cut the story short a little bit. In the end, he had to tell me. So there's no need to be embarrassed if you didn't get the rule. What's this sequence consist of? 1. No, how many ones? 1, 1. Oh, yes. What's this next sequence consist of? Oh, 2 ones. Oh, yes, that's right. This next one is 1, 2, followed by 1, 1. Oh, yes. 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1. You get the rule. And that's quite an interesting sequence. And I was just going off at the end of term, and on the plane to Boston, I think I was going to, I fiddled with this and came up with a really rather remarkable conclusion. On average, each of these sequences is about 1.357 times the one before it. I mean, not exactly, but it gets closer to being this fixed number times the length of the one in front of it. So it gets bigger and bigger and bigger by powers of 1.357 all the time. And I proved that that number, I hope I've got it right, by the way, was an algebraic number, don't worry if you don't know what that means, of degree 71. And it seemed to me the stupidest problem you could conceivably imagine that led to the most complicated answer you could conceivably imagine. Anyway, that's been called by some people a look and say sequence. I called it, I wrote a little paper about it in the Undergraduate Magazine of Cambridge, and I called it The Weird and Wonderful Chemistry of Audioactive Decay. Audioactive because you say this, and then in some sense, the structure decays, although the thing's getting longer all the time, and it's like radioactive. And I showed that there are some sequences, in fact, if I go one step further, or maybe two steps further, 1, 1, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 1. Yes, this is it. If I take a red pen so that you can see it more easily, I'm putting a red spot there. It turns out that if you develop this sequence here, it always ends in a 2, because you know, you've got 1, 2 at the end of it next time. Here you've got, maybe it's 2 twos, I don't know. But anyway, it'll be 2s. So the left-hand sequence always ends in a 2. And the right-hand sequence, well, look, it goes 1, 1, 1, 3, 1, 2, something or other, and then 3, 1, 1, 3, 1, 1, and then 1, 3, 2, 1, 1, 3, etc. and then 1, 1, 1, 3, 1, 2, and here we are. This sequence and this sequence begin in the same way, and you can see that. So this sequence will begin 3, 1, 1, 3, and so on, and then this is 1, 3, 2. What I'm trying to say is that this will always begin with a 1 or a 3, and I remarked before that this always ends in a 2. So what's interesting about that is if you follow this sequence as if it's all there is, and you follow this sequence as if it's all there is, and then you stick the results together, it's correct. And so I say this sequence splits. It's a compound of two atoms or elements. And it turns out that there are precisely 92 common elements in this thing. And you know, there are 92, historically there were 92 common elements in the world. And that just struck my fancy. There's no connection whatsoever. But I call these elements hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and so on. And
all the way through to uranium.
Yes. This sequence of length 10 is not an element. It's the compound of this sequence 1, 1, 1, 3, 2, and this sequence 1, 3, 2, 1, 1. In that, if you follow the, let's call those L and R, if you follow L and follow R independently, you still get the right answer. You only need to consider elements that aren't compounds, or sequences that aren't compounds, and we call those elements or atoms. And it turns out there are 92 of them. I mean, you can do various other things. For instance, I gave a lecture on this in Acadia University in Nova Scotia. There was this Nobel Prize winning physicist, David Park, at the lecture. And he said, have you thought about Roman numerals? One. Oh, this is two ones. This is three ones. Oh, this is four ones. And the Roman numeral for four is IV. And then this is 1, 1, 1, 5, 1, 1. And this gives rise to another problem of the same kind. And it turns out that this depends on the root of a 20th degree equation.